गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू ऑनलाइन बायोलॉजी क्लासेस। वी आर ऑन चैप्टर 3 द सेल एंड द टॉपिक फॉर टुडे इज साइटोप्लाज्म एंड सेल ऑर्गेनेल्स। नाउ इन द प्रीवियस लेसन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट प्रोटोप्लाज्म व्हिच इज अ जेली लाइक सब्सटेंस इनसाइड द सेल मेम्ब्रेन एंड I have taught you that protoplasm consists of two parts. One part we have already discussed, that is the nucleus, and another part is the cytoplasm. So today we will discuss about the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm, it is the semi-solid, colorless, jelly-like part and enclosed within the cell membrane. Now this, what is a cytoplasm? It is a jelly-like substance which is semi-solid in nature, which does not have any color, and it is enclosed inside the cell membrane. And most of the cellular activities or the activities which are done by a cell occur inside the cytoplasm. And who helps the cytoplasm for doing these various activities of the cell? Cell organelles. Now, what are they? We will discuss that also today itself. First, let us discuss what are the functions of cytoplasm. First of all, it helps in distribution of nutrients within the cell. Cytoplasm helps in the transport or distribution of any kind of nutrient inside the cell only. Secondly, it helps in exchange of material between cell organelles. If one material has to be transported from one organelle to other, it will be transported with the help of this jelly-like substance which is called cytoplasm. Now we will study about cell organelles. What are cell organelles? If we look at this diagram, first of all, you can see the labeling Golgi bodies, vacuole, then ribosome, then endoplasmic reticulum, rough and smooth endoplasmic reticulum, lysosome, mitochondria, all these structures which you can see inside that jelly-like yellow color portion, they all are called as cell organelles. So there are various cell organelles inside the cytoplasm, and they only help the cell to perform different kind of activities. In order to perform various activities, a cell has many small structures in the cytoplasm called cell organelles. And some of the cell organelles we are going to learn are mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes, Golgi bodies, lysosomes, centrosomes, plastids, and vacuoles are some of the cell organelles which we are going to discuss in this chapter. You can see different structure of various cell organelles. We will discuss them one by one. So the first two cell organelles that we are going to discuss are mitochondria and endoplasmic reticulum. Coming back on the diagram, the last two labelings which you can see, the last labeling is mitochondrion. Can you see? It is present in both plant cell as well as in animal cell. And the second last labeling, rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum diagram, you can also see the position of both of them inside a cell. So let us study about these two. Mitochondria. The name of the cell organelle is mitochondria. Shape of this cell organelle is like rod shape or spherical shape. It is not round, exactly circular, but it is in a shape of rod, as you can see in the picture. And it is very, very small. What is the structure of mitochondria? Bound by two membranes. Now this mitochondria is having two membranes. One will be the outer layer and one will be the inner layer. If you see in the diagram, both the membranes are labeled, the outer membrane and the inner membrane. And the inner membrane are like folded like structure, finger like folded structures. You can see there are folds in the inner membrane. These folds are called as cristae. These fold or finger like folded structure inside the mitochondria, they are called as cristae. Description. They are known as powerhouse of the cell. Now this is very important. Which cell organelle is known as the powerhouse of the cell? It is mitochondria. And why it is called powerhouse of the cell? Because they are the sites of respiration. Now we all are well aware that we also do the process of respiration, that is breathing, and plants also do the process of respiration. So who help our body in the process of respiration? The mitochondria present inside the cell, it helps the body for the process of respiration. So what happens in respiration? During respiration, energy is released in the form of adenosine triphosphate, and the short form is ATP. What is ATP? It is a kind of molecule in which after respiration, whatever energy is produced, it is that energy is stored in these ATP molecule, and these ATP molecules are inside the mitochondria. That is why they are called the powerhouse of the cell, because they store energy for the cell. Next cell organelle is endoplasmic reticulum. What is the shape of it? Network of tube-like structure in the cytoplasm. You can see the diagram over here. They are like web-like structure, and they are like in a form of network attached to one another. And they are surrounding the nucleus. You can see it very easily. Nucleus is surrounded by endoplasmic reticulum. Structure. The outer surface is smooth or rough. Now endoplasmic reticulum may be of two type. One is the smooth endoplasmic reticulum and another is rough endoplasmic reticulum, as you can see in the second last labeling. Rough means which are having ribosomes attached on them. You can see small dotted structures attached on the ribosome. And that is why the surface of endoplasmic reticulum appears to be rough or uneven, because what is present on the endoplasmic reticulum? Ribosomes are attached. They are also a kind of cell organelle. And on the other hand, you can see in animal cell smooth endoplasmic reticulum, and as well as in plant cell you can see smooth endoplasmic reticulum, because on these endoplasmic reticulum ribosomes are not attached, so they will be smooth, the surface will be smooth. So the outer surface is smooth or rough depending on the presence or absence of ribosome. What are the function of endoplasmic reticulum? It gives internal support to the cell. As you can see, the structure of it is like a network. So it gives support to the cell, and it also provides pathway for the transport of material within the cell. So easily any material can go from outside of the endoplasmic reticulum, through the endoplasmic reticulum, and inside the nucleus. Why? Because endoplasmic reticulum over here are attached to the nucleus. So the materials can also be easily transported with the help of these network-like structure, which are called endoplasmic reticulum. Another two cell organelles are ribosomes and Golgi bodies. Ribosomes. What are the shape of ribosome? Small and round. Where I have told you, just now I have told you, ribosomes are attached on the endoplasmic reticulum. Again, you can see in the diagram, these are ribosomes which are attached on the endoplasmic reticulum. And if they will be attached, the reticulum will be called rough endoplasmic reticulum. Description. Found in free state in the cytoplasm or attached to the endoplasmic reticulum. Either you can see the ribosomes are small round like structures. Over here it is not shown. Either they will be found floating free in the cytoplasm, or either they will be attached to other cell organelles or to the endoplasmic reticulum specifically. Function. They make protein in the cell. This is very important again. Now, therefore, they are called as protein factory of the cell. Why are they called protein factory? Who are called protein factory of the cell? Ribosomes are called protein factory of the cell. Why? Because they make protein for the cell. Protein, as we know, that it is a very important nutrient. Now, Golgi bodies. What is the structure of Golgi body look like? You can see in the picture, made up of stack of parallel flattened disc. Now, if you know what are pancakes, if you make pancakes at home and you just keep on putting one pancake on another, it is called a stack of pancakes. So similarly, the Golgi body look like stack of pancakes. They are almost circular or spherical in shape, but they always appear in the layers. As you can see, one on the other, the discs are attached. They are also called dictyosomes. Now again, this is an important term. What is another name of Golgi body? Dictyosomes. What is the function of Golgi body now? It helps in the synthesis of cell wall. So Golgi body help in the formation of cell wall. Then transportation of material within the cell. Just like endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi body also help in the transportation of material in the cell. So these are the four cell organelles that we have discussed today. In today's lesson, we will continue with some more cell organelles in the upcoming lessons. So do revise the topics, clear your doubts if you have any, and have a good day.